Tammy Lynn Sytch. Tamara Lynn Sytch, born December 7, 1972, widely known by her ring name Sunny, is an American professional wrestling manager, valet, and ring announcer. Sytch achieved great success as Sunny within the World Wrestling Federation, WWF, later WWE, during the 1990s and is considered the first WWF diva. In 1996, America Online named Sytch, Sunny, the most downloaded celebrity on the internet. She later performed under her birth name in Extreme Championship Wrestling, ECW, World Championship Wrestling, WCW, and Ring of Honor. Sytch was inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame in 2011. Early life. Sytch grew up in a strict family with a father retired from the United States Navy. Upon entering Smoky Mountain Wrestling in 1993, her fictional in-character storyline presented her as having come from studying pre-law at Wellesley College in Massachusetts. She then switched to pre-med at the University of Tennessee, with the ambition to be a plastic or orthopedic surgeon. During her first year of college, she worked as a freelance photographer. Professional wrestling career. Smoky Mountain Wrestling, 1992-1995. Sytch started out traveling with her boyfriend Chris Candido to make some extra money. In late 1992, she signed a six-month deal with Smoky Mountain Wrestling. She first appeared on screen as Tammy Fytch in 1993. She played a villain, who idolized Hillary Clinton. In her first storyline with the company, she threatened to file a sexual discrimination lawsuit due to the lack of prominent positions offered to females. She managed Brian Lee to the heavyweight championship and also began accompanying Candido in his matches. By May 1994, she was managing the two men as a tag team, which won the tag team championship from the Rock and Roll Express. Both Sytch and Candido, however, left the promotion in early 1995 for jobs with the World Wrestling Federation, WWF. World Wrestling Federation, 1995-1998. In late 1994, Sytch was contacted by the WWF, and she began appearing as Tamara Murphy, a commentator for live event news segments during syndicated WWF television shows. 1 month later, Candido joined the WWF, and the duo began appearing as Sunny and Skip, known collectively as the Villainous Fitness Fanatics, the Body Donnas. Zip later joined the team, and Sunny was in their corner when they won the tag team championship over the Godwins at WrestleMania 12. In 1996, she won Pro Wrestling Illustrated's Manager of the Year award. She was also AOL's most downloaded woman of that year. Weeks later, the Godwins regained the championship, and Sunny turned on the Body Donnas in favor of the new champions. She then turned on the Godwins and helped the Smoking Guns win the tag team championship. After the Smoking Guns lost the title at In Your House 10, Mind Games, she fired them in the middle of the ring. She spent a short time as the manager of Farooq Asad, aiding him in his feud over the Intercontinental Championship with Mark Marrow and his valet Sable. Sytch then began acting as host for several WWF television shows, including Livewire and Shotgun Saturday Night. In addition, she appeared on MTV's Singled Out and Entertainment Tonight. Meanwhile, Candido left the WWF for Extreme Championship Wrestling, ECW, and it was not long before she began making guest appearances with him in the promotion. In August 1997, she appeared at ECW's Hardcore Heaven 1997 pay-per-view. In 1998, Sunny became a face and briefly became the manager for the Legion of Doom 2000, leading them to a win in a Tag Team Championship No. 1 Contender Battle Royal at WrestleMania 14. Sunny would continue to manage them until she was released in July 1998 amid rumors of backstage problems with Rena Sable Marrow and an addiction to painkillers, as well as no-showing several appearances. Extreme Championship Wrestling, 1998-1999. After being released by the WWF in July 1998, Sytch joined Extreme Championship Wrestling, ECW. She made her debut at Heatwave 4 days after her WWF release. Now billed as Tammy Lynn Sytch, she assisted Candido in his win over Lance Storm and their subsequent feud. By September, Storm introduced his own valet, a parody of Sytch, Tammy Lynn Bytch, later known as Dawn Marie. Later that year, amid more rumors of drug use, Sytch and Candido took some time off of television. When the duo returned, Candido realigned with Shane Douglas Triple Threat, and Sytch began a feud with Douglas's manager Francine. The feud was cut short when Sytch was arrested after violating a restraining order filed by her mother. After a brief tour of Australia, she returned in October 1999 on an episode of ECW on TNN, where she talked openly about her past drug issues and reformation. After a brief feud with Dawn Marie, there were rumors that Sytch had been found passed out in a locker room. Candido and Sytch left the promotion in December 1999. World Championship Wrestling, 2000. After appearing in Extreme Pro Wrestling, XPW, in early 2000, both Sytch and Candido signed on with World Championship Wrestling, WCW. Candido debuted in March of that year and Sytch debuted 1 month later at Spring Stampede, helping him win the WCW Cruiserweight Championship in a match against the artist formerly known as Prince Iokia. She then feuded with Iokia's valet Paisley. The short-lived feud came to a conclusion at Slamboree when the artist and Paisley stripped Tammy's dress off to reveal her undergarments following Candido's singles victory over Iokia. Sytch and Candido then briefly feuded with Crowbar and Daphne. Candido later dropped the title, which marked the end of the couple's run with the company. As in the past, Sytch's departure was surrounded by rumors of drug abuse. Independent Circuit, 2018. After being released from WCW, the duo landed in Extreme Pro Wrestling where she managed Candido to a title, the XPW World Heavyweight title, once again. Candido and Sytch parted ways with XPW and started touring other independent wrestling promotions. In the spring of 2003, Sytch and Candido moved to Puerto Rico and were set to work for Victor Quiñones International Wrestling Association promotion. Sabu convinced them to work for Carlos Colon's rival World Wrestling Council, WWC, promotion instead. After 6 months, the couple quit the promotion and headed back to the States. Upon their return to the States, both Sytch and Candido briefly lived with former ECW wrestler Hack Myers in his home in Florida. After the death of Candido, Sytch became regularly involved in the independent circuit again. Sytch made appearances as a referee for NWS Wrestling in May 2005 and attended a Chris Candido Memorial Show on June 4, 2005. Also, Sytch was a part of Hardcore Homecoming on June 10, 2005. She first came out with Johnny Grunge and Pitbull No. 1 to do a tribute to former ECW wrestlers who had recently died. Among those honored were Candido, Pitbull No. 2, and Rocco Rock. They were interrupted by Danny Doring and Roadkill, but 911 cleared them out of the ring. During this time period, Sytch appeared at the New Jersey-based NWA Cyberspace promotion. Soon after Sytch's departure from NWA Cyberspace, the New Jersey-based National Wrestling Superstars, NWS, became her new primary wrestling promotion. She appeared on a handful of the promotion's shows in the summer, and on June 3, 2006, she managed Lex Luger to victory over Johnny Candido. Prior to the bout, a presentation was held from the Manasquan Elks Lodge to the Chris Candido Memorial Fund. The Elks Lodge donated $500 to the fund, with the money being used towards a scholarship for a Manasquan high school student. In spite of the prior ruling, Sytch returned to NWA Shockwave, formerly NWA Cyberspace, in 2006 as a featured headliner. On December 1, 2006, Sytch was appointed the new commissioner of NWA Shockwave. Immediately following this announcement, Sytch declared all Shockwave championship titles vacant and informed fans that new heavyweight and internet champions would be crowned on January 13. On December 22, 2007, Sytch won her first championship, the WSU Championship, after defeating the champion Alicia at a Women's Superstars Uncensored, WSU, show in Lake Hiawatha, New Jersey, holding the title until March 21, 2008, when she lost the title to Nikki Rocks in a three-way match that also included Alexa Thatcher. Sytch turned heel at WSU's J-Cup tournament a day later, when she appeared as the villainous manager for Dawn Marie in her first round match against Becky Bayless, which Bayless won via disqualification. Sytch made an appearance at a Ring of Honor show on December 29, 2007 held at New York City, seated at ringside during a non-title three-way match where Daisy Hayes defeated fellow Raw regulars Lacey, and then Shimmer champion Sara Del Rey. Upon the conclusion of the match, Lacey verbally assaulted Sytch and accused her of denigrating women's roles in professional wrestling, which supposedly resulted in women's wrestlers not being taken seriously in the industry. She also threatened to assault Sytch, but Hayes made the save on Sytch's behalf. Sytch made a few more appearances for Raw in 2008, where she repeatedly offered her services to Austin Aries but was turned down. On the April 12th Raw show, Larry Sweeney announced that he had opened a diva school and invited Sytch to be the trainer, an offer she said she would consider. Sytch made an appearance at Dynamite Championship Wrestling's 9-year anniversary event in February 2012. She would be the official host of the event. She also made an appearance for Pennsylvania Premier Wrestling on September 14, 2013 at the Back at It event in Freeland, Pennsylvania. A week after being released from jail in October 2018, Sytch announced via Facebook that she would be taking bookings for what she claimed would be her final 9 to 12 months of appearances before retiring to a private life. WWE appearances, 2007, 2009, 2011. Sytch made an appearance on the 15th anniversary of Raw. Sytch, as Sunny, participated at WrestleMania XXV on April 5, 2009 in the 25 Diva Battle Royal for the crown of Miss WrestleMania but was eliminated by Beth Phoenix. Sytch was inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame by the entire roster of WWE Divas on April 2, 2011. Personal life. Sytch attended the same high school as her longtime boyfriend, Chris Candido, who would later introduce her to the professional wrestling industry. Sytch regularly managed Candido throughout his career and remained with him until his death in 2005. By 2007, she was once again in school, studying medical technology. Sytch had a 9-month affair with Shawn Michaels. In 1997, Michaels insinuated that Bret Hart had been having an affair with Sytch, which Hart denied. The accusation caused marital problems for Hart, leading to a backstage confrontation with Michaels. Sytch was friends with Hart and would entertain his children whenever they followed him on tour. Sytch walked out of Raw the night after, and in reaction to the Montreal Screwjob, the incident in which WWF owner Vince McMahon cost Hart the WWF Championship. Sytch was rushed to the hospital in 2001 after her appendix burst, which required time off from wrestling to heal. While in jail in 2013, Sytch said that she was diagnosed with cervical cancer but underwent a hysterectomy and was later diagnosed as cancer-free. She released an autobiography, A Star Shattered, The Rise and Fall and Rise of Wrestling Diva Tammy Sunny Sytch, on February 4, 2016. Legal issues. In 2012, Sytch was arrested 5 times in a 4-week span, for disorderly conduct, third-degree burglary, and 3 counts of violating a protective order. She was arrested a 6th time in January 2013, also for violating a protective order. Sytch served 114 days in jail and was released in May 2013. Throughout May and June 2015, Sytch was pulled over and arrested in Pennsylvania three times for DUI. Sytch pled guilty to all three of the main charges, with the lesser charges being dropped. During a July 2016 interview with Bill Apter, Sytch said she agreed to plead guilty because she was blackout drunk during the arrests and that she did not remember them, stating that it was the worst relapse of her life. In January 2016, Sytch pled guilty to driving while under suspension. A judge sentenced her to 90 days in jail on August 18, but counted her 97 days in rehab as time served. On September 12, 2016 was rushed to Palmerton Hospital, from her home in Palmerton, Pennsylvania, where alcohol was discovered. This led to a charge for violating the parole stemming from her three Pennsylvania DUI cases from 2015. Sytch remained in jail on these charges through her arraignment in January 2017. She was fined $1,496.45 for the remaining charges and was released on February 3, 2017. While on probation, Sytch was arrested in New Jersey for two DUIs on January 23 and February 2, 2018, and was also charged with fleeing the scene of an accident in relation to the February 2 arrest. After failing to appear in court for either case, she was arrested on February 27, 2018 for two fugitive from justice charges and six counts of contempt of court, and was placed in the Monmouth County Correctional Institution. While she was being processed, it was discovered that she was a fugitive from justice due to her parole from Carbon County Correctional Facility in Pennsylvania having been revoked in August 2017. Sytch was subsequently extradited to Pennsylvania on March 23 and remained at the Carbon County Correctional Facility in Nesquehoning until she was paroled on October 9, 2018. A bench warrant was issued for Sytch in Pennsylvania on February 15, 2019, and the Carbon County Probation Department filed a motion to revoke Sytch's October 2018 parole. This was the result of Sytch's failure to continue her payment plan with Pennsylvania to cover the state's legal costs for her case. After making payments of $120 to the state in both October and November 2018, Sytch had ceased making further payments. On February 23, 2019, Sytch was pulled over in Seaside Heights, New Jersey, where Seaside Heights police arrested her for driving while intoxicated. They also issued a summons for having an open alcohol container in a motor vehicle, consumption of alcohol in a motor vehicle, and reckless driving. Additionally, the Ocean County Sheriff's Office, who were also on the scene, issued her a summons for failure to stop at a stop sign, driving the wrong way on a one-way street, driving with a suspended driver's license, and careless driving. Seaside Heights released Sytch into the custody of the Homedale Police Department after it was discovered that she still had outstanding warrants in both Homedale, New Jersey for $1,500 and Knowlton Township, New Jersey for $1,000. She was charged with contempt of court, disobedience slash resistance of court command on both warrants. Sytch saw a judge via video conference concerning the Homedale warrant but remained in custody at Monmouth County Correctional Institution in Freehold Township, New Jersey, pending her remaining charges. On March 20, Sytch was extradited from Monmouth County back to Carbon County Correctional Facility to address her Pennsylvania charges. A court hearing for Sytch's Pennsylvania charges is scheduled for April 5, 2019. However, on March 26, Sytch's attorney, Matthew Glenn Schnell, filed a motion to withdraw as her counsel. Adult Entertainment. Sytch has claimed that, in 1997, Playboy had approached her and offered a six-figure sum to pose nude for the magazine. Sytch stated that she declined the offer because she didn't feel that she was emotionally ready to do something like that. Rena Sable Mero, with whom Sytch had real-life animosity, later refuted Sytch's claim that she was approached for a possible photo shoot. From 2001 to 2003, however, Sytch regularly posed nude for Missy Hyatt's adult website Wrestling Vixens. In later years, Sytch said she regretted taking part in the website due to money she claimed she never received, as well as the sexual actions some of the other models performed in their own photo and video shoots. In 2016, Vivid Entertainment released a pornographic film featuring Sytch titled Sunny Side Up, In Through the Back Door. Championships and accomplishments.